Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum. Straight talk about you and your money. Now from the BizTalk studios, here is Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Gary Kaltbaum, your host. A thanks for being with us today. Glad you're here, ladies and gentlemen. Happy that you are listening. It is December 26th. It is Tuesday. It is 2023. And the reason I know this, because I got delivered today my daily appointment Dayminder books. I have one for trading. I have one for exercise. Keep myself in order. I recommend them highly. And amazingly, I have to tell you, if you buy it through the company, let me put it better. If you buy it through Amazon, it's like 60% below buying at the company, which begs the question, how does Amazon do that? If a company charges $75 for a Dayminder, you know, it's one of these books, it's, you know, you put notes in there and appointments and stuff. If the company itself is charging $75 for a Dayminder, how is it possible that Amazon can charge $36 and get away with it? Amazon is in competition with the company that's producing these things and kicking their butts. Interesting. It tells you how much profit there is in these things, and maybe Amazon is just loss leadering it. I don't know. It's just unbelievable. I went and got these tax folders a month ago. Oh, the Post-it notes. I paid $13. They were $28 at Office Depot on Amazon. Amazing. Just so you know, I don't know Jeff Bezos, and I guess he's not running the show anymore. Amazon doesn't even know I'm mentioning this. But if you don't look at Amazon but before you're buying something, you're crazy. And speaking of that, I was in a Costco and in Raleigh, North Carolina this past week, the last 3 days. So I went to Costco, and I haven't been to one in a while. We have a Sam's Club near where I'm at. What an amazing and efficient, unbelievable company Costco is. Just so you know, and I was with the father of my goddaughters, I actually hung around Costco just walking around just trying to figure some things out, how they're able. Just so you know, when you go into Costco and you see these big gigantic pallets of food and all kinds of stuff, do you realize how much inventory control they have to do and have to have it as a science, not to have too much, especially the perishables? They have it to a science. And little did I know, you could get like a 4,000-foot TV for $400. I haven't bought a TV in a while. I was just so impressed with Costco. And I've been to Sam's Club a few times. But amazing. And you know what else they do very good? They know where to position things. I was just walking around, and all I kept saying to myself was, how the hell didn't I buy this stock 20 years ago and just sit on it? The positioning of things. You should see their meat department. Holy crap. Amazing. So kudos. You know, I love great companies, and you know, we ripped on bad companies here, but wow. Wow. And of course, the place was packed. Big time. And nobody was shoplifting. I guess you need a membership to even get in. I wonder what happened if somebody would go in there and then try to shoplift. I gather they have some plain clothes in there. Anyway, just wanted to let you know a little bit about the trip. The airports were pretty busy. Coming back, not. I had no delays whatsoever. It was great. Let's see, I flew to New York, Delta, to Raleigh, United. I'll just continue to complain about Newark Airport, though. Man, oh, man. How hard is it to put people through security quicker? Amazing. but they try hard, and flew Southwest to home. And unfortunately, Southwest is still a great airline. They're not even close to what they used to be 10 years ago. You know, it's the people that make airlines. They still have great people. Just something about how they run it, you know, from go and they need to work on that again. I don't know if it's because Gary Kelly left. He was a great CEO. I don't know. Anyway, that was my happenings the last 3 days. Looked like business was pretty brisk, but you really can't tell small sampling. But the markets certainly don't care about anything that may be a negative out there. It still remains on a positive. Let's get right into it. You know, last Wednesday, in the last 2 hours, the Dow dropped 500 points. And I'm always a big believer of the market will shoot across the bow, will throw something at you as a wake-up call, for lack of a better word. I came on the show Wednesday just letting you know there is potential here for a shot across the bow wake-up call. Market's very stretched and extended to the upside. Big dose of bullishness. Bears have gone by the wayside. Very overdue. Just letting you know, so far the market's forgot it. And in fact, and I'm surprised by it, that some things have moved above the highs of last Wednesday. The semiconductors, the mid caps, the small caps, certain names. Stunning. Now, maybe we can chalk it up to end of year, because usually have that seasonality, usually. Who knows? We'll keep on trucking, though, trying to figure out life in general. And let me just state for the record again, we're stretched, extended, overbought, bought a big dose of bullishness, no bears. The charlatans are lying on, you know, when you go watch them. Oh, yeah, I did this, I did that, I did this, I did that. Oh, yeah, sure, thank you, right, okay. And we'll see how the rest of the year goes, but just... no argument. And it's being led by the semis and financials and other sundry things. But that's one hell of a 1-2 punch. It's our number one and number two areas. And I have to tell you, I saw the financials turn the corner. I can't believe I didn't buy the crap out of them. What can I tell you? You live, you learn, you put your best foot forward. That's how we roll. So on the day, the Dow was up 159, S&P 20, NASDAQ 81, NASDAQ 100, 101, transports 40, SOX up 74, was up 90. You had a little sell-off towards the close. You were actually at up like 220 and 110. So a little pullback, but I call it no biggie. And if there's anything that's, you know, drifting right now and not really on the move, Apple, Amazon, Adobe, Microsoft, Google, well, Google's up near highs. So there's some mega cap names that are just stalled here. And we'll see if the other things pull back, they get going. But I really can't complain about too much at this juncture. If things change, we'll let you know. If we see more shots across the bow, we'll let you know. But this two-month move is for the books. And I say for the books, not... If it was breaking out of range at the start, that's a different story. We were coming off of the bear market low in the Russell 2000. We were at bear market lows. We had 1,000 new yearly lows. It was stunning. And the crash in yields has done that trick. That's what did it. Frankly, I don't care what did it. I just care what happens. But that's what did it. And there's still areas not in shape. But one of them we've been telling you to avoid, but in the last few days said was perking up and's got a shot here, is the oils. So you may want to put those on your screen. Let me tell you why. Number one, the price action. Number two, the price action of oil. But number three, besides the pipelines, I now have about seven or eight names that are setting up pretty damn well. Seven or eight names. What is that going to do? There's probably 400 oil stocks. Well, you start somewhere. And if you go look at the exchange-traded funds, the OIH, the XLE, and the XOP, they're trying to turn the corner. Not 100% when you're dealing with oil. You know, dealing with commodity. Things can change because OPEC opens its yapper. But just letting you know, oil better. Now, not great at the pump if oil prices go up, but if they bounce up a little bit, it's no big deal. Breakdowns, you know, we scan, and I already scanned 1,500 names. Hardly any. Up next, we'll continue with the markets, news of the day, whatever else today. Oh, the politics today. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
I'm Gary Kaltbaum, host of the nationally syndicated radio show Investor's Edge. We're not just handsome radio people. We manage investors' money for a living, specializing in fee-based discretionary money management. No big commissions, just a fee on the assets that's managed. We also provide a full range of personalized services, including retirement planning, fixed income, and educational needs, all to assist you in achieving your financial goals. Understanding not all individuals have the same needs, we'll carefully evaluate your personal goals to determine a proper investment strategy. If your current approach to investing is not getting you to where you would like to be, call us to make an appointment for a complimentary portfolio review. The number to call is 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. Investment advisory services offered through Kaltbaum Capital Management.
It's time to switch on the integrator units and get the brain cells working.
You're listening to...
Hey, this promises to be fun.
Investor's Edge.
The last bastion of quality programming.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
It doesn't get better than this.
Okay. Steely Dan. They are playing with the Eagles on tour, but it's only one of the Steely Dan, as one of the good men passed away a few years ago. I will be going to that. I'm not going to miss that. And I've seen the Eagles, I think, 5 times in the last 10 years. Something like that. Last one was at Hyde Park in London. It was pretty darn good. Let's do a little bit of the news and then we'll get back in the markets. You know what's frustrating? The New York Times. We know the amazing part about there's a lot of Jewish people that work at the New York Times, yet they continue to be anti... They'll say it's anti-Israel, but they can't say that. But they're just anti-Israel, anti-Jew, which is total Jewish hate. Do you know what they did? They allowed an op-ed, opinion piece, from Hamas. They're quoting Hamas on how many Palestinians supposedly have died. They let... an accessory to murder and rape and kidnapping do an op-ed against Israel. Oh, but Gary, free speech. Oh, will you let the head of ISIS do an op-ed in your newspaper? Would you let Adolf Hitler do an op-ed in the newspaper? That's who these people are. Yet they allowed it. This sick in the frickin' mind. It's unbelievable to watch. And frankly, I couldn't give a crap about these young people that don't have a clue, wouldn't even know where Israel on a map is. Oh, the river to the sea. Well, what's the name of the river? Oh, blah, blah. Screw them all. Remember, tic-tac-toe. But the influencers, the teachers, the presidents of college, the media, it is unbelievable. Where did this all come from? And I'm just waiting for every Jew that works at the New York Times to just quit. I guess job over principle? I don't know. Anyway, that was in the news and pissed me off, amongst other things when it comes to what's going on. But you already know where I stand. In the news, Kamala Harris. She puts up a Christmas message, I guess maybe on Twitter, X, a picture of her and her husband, God bless her, with a gas stove. You know, the ones the Biden's trying to outlaw. Just letting you know. What do we tell you about these people? You understand. John Kerry in the private jet to his big yacht. Lives in, what, a 30,000 square foot house. The amount of carbon he emits on top after he eats beans. We will never reach what he uses in our lifetime, what he uses in a month. And I can go on and on. You get the point. It's amazing to watch. Also in the news, and we're going to take on all comers here, President Biden now blaming the media for his poll numbers. What, do you know, I'm showing polls that say 14% of the people believe the economy's in the crapper. And on, all the poll numbers. And what have we told you about that? How can that be? How can you have a stock market near the highs? How can you have unemployment 3.7%? How can you have GDP just around 5%? And you think the president sucks? How is that possible? That is not normal. I'm letting you know, normal, and I said it on TV the other day, you'd be at 60% right now. I'm telling you, this is what's going on, and I have a good ear. Very good ear. Nobody trusts him. The left doesn't even trust him. Certainly the right doesn't trust him. Nobody believes anything good in the economy has come from him. I'm just telling you how it goes. Anything good, nobody believes. I'm not saying right or wrong. But that's the story. You know I can get into my $2 trillion in debt this year. And the giveaways and all the other crap this guy does. You know, the control freakism of the country. But nobody cares because they don't trust him. And he could talk blue in the face. But Trump is kicking his butt in the polls. Nikki Haley's kicking his butt in the polls. Because nobody trusts him. They believe anything good has nothing to do with him. And he's caused a lot of problems. The border. And just so you know, inflation. They can talk blue in the face on inflation. But the rate of inflation's down, but the prices are way up. Try renting a place. Try buying a place. And of course, that's a lot caused by Jay Powell. Do you know what I was just in Publix here in Florida. They're giving away 2-for-1 party size bags of chips. I just noticed that today. There's only one problem. The party size looks around one half the size of what it used to be. Shrinkflation. And you know, I've discussed with you prices for certain food and everything that, wait, hey, whoa, yay, great, oh, fantastic. It was up 25% last year, only up 5% this year. Look how good we are at the White House. No, the price is up 30-something percent. So he's getting whooped on that, and there's nothing he's going to be able to do about it. Nobody cares. Nobody trusts him. Poor guy. And then there's Trump. I'm going to read something to you. I don't know if my music's going to play before I get into it or not, but I'm going to read what he put out for Christmas. A Merry Christmas. I don't know if this was on Truth Social. I don't know what. And the amazing part of what he put out is it made so much sense. everything I have complained to about of what this administration is doing in his whatever he put out made so much sense. I think he's listening to my show. And then he blows it all to hell because of, what do we tell you? No discipline. No discipline. And you people that love Trump, you need to email him or wire him or speak to whoever you know from him. If he would just leave the good ideas out there and shut the hell up and just lower the tone, nope. Because the egomaniac in him can't. And look at the trouble he's gotten in. And look at the trouble others that have aligned themselves with him. Look at Rudy Giuliani. Just filed bankruptcy, this guy. Up next, we'll play it for you. Then the markets again. And whatever else. This is the one only Investor's Edge.
Listening to
America is talking
Investor's Edge.
He's got to be pleased with that. The crowd is just on his feet here. He's a Cinderella boy.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
Comes highly recommended. You're going to feel better if you talk to him.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. So we've been doing a little ripping. Let me read the part that's great that Trump puts out. You ready? With their open borders, inflation, Afghanistan surrender, green new scam, took the words right out of my mouth, high taxes, no energy independence, which is not true though, by the way. I don't know if you know this, we are producing more than ever, but it has nothing to do with Biden, it has everything to do with the oil companies. Woke military, I'm not so sure what that is. Russia, Ukraine, correct. Israel, Iran, correct. All electric car lunacy, I'll agree. And so much more. So most of that, bingo. And I got to tell you, they're layups. They are layups. Do you see what's going on at the border? Brought to you by one man and his decision-making? For starters, do you remember Afghanistan? Do you know we left $1 billion worth of artillery, our armory, and everything there? Do you know the women there are now back to the Stone Ages again because of the Taliban? We were there and we were really, and we didn't have that many people there. Just a colossal, moronic, imbecilic, doofus-like move by this administration. But then Trump screws the whole damn thing up. Because at the start of those words, he goes here. Merry Christmas to all, including crooked Joe Biden's only hope, deranged Jack Smith, the out-of-control lunatic. You know who Jack Smith is? He's the guy going after Trump, and you're calling him deranged and lunatic, and you think he's going to be kind to you? Trump's acting like he doesn't have 91 counts against him. I continue. Fresh from the swamp, to unprecedented in parentheses, to help him with his poorly executed witch hunt against Trump and MAGA. Trump is great at saying they're going after you too, which is BS. Then the stupidity again. Included also are world leaders, both good and bad, but none of which are as evil and sick as the thugs we have inside our country, who with their open... Really? So you're saying that Putin and the yutz in North Korea and the dude running Syria, they're not as bad as the people running this country? Oh, sure. Okay. And then he ends with this. And so much more are looking to destroy our once great USA. Next line. May they rot in hell. Again, Merry Christmas. You people that want him to be president again, better get to him. You got that? Because people will vote in certain ways and then they won't vote. Trump lost the last election to an 80-year-old lifer in Washington because he pissed off so many that would have otherwise voted for him. And just so you know, on a lot of ballots, listen carefully, Republicans were voted for and Trump wasn't voted for. In Georgia, a ton of votes were for Republicans except for Trump. And the same goes for other states. Most people want a statesman. And it's okay to rip the other side. May they rot in hell. I know a lot of people will say, oh, that's no big deal. But there's a... If 0.1% think that's over the top, he may lose a state. Now, let me be clear. If the election was today, Biden's out. Trump's in. Seriously. Biden's out. Trump is in. Because you now have a record of Biden, and they don't trust anything good. And they see the border every day. They see Israel, Ukraine, and Russia. We just find out that China told Biden when they had the meeting, oh, Taiwan's next. And they didn't disclose. Remember, Biden was elected based on getting rid of Trump's chaos. And he's made it so much worse geopolitically. So it's going to be an interesting next, what are we, almost January? 10 months and change. But for all you Trump people, you may want to just try and get him to dial it back and just talk about them policies, because I got news for you. Biden is easy pickings. Seriously, a mannequin can beat Biden right now. If he can't get even crappy poll numbers with the GDP where it is, it tells you everything. I don't think anything good has to do with him. We'll keep you informed. With no bias, no agenda, no ulterior motive. Why? We hate them all. They've earned it. And I wish you all the best. I wish you all the luck. And just remember, if you tie your life to what a president does, you may want to think twice about it. Next. I got a bunch of emails this weekend, Gary, and this is from quite a few people out of nowhere, that this market looks and feels like it did in 99. And in March of 2000, look out below. Interesting. And why did I get those emails? Because people have good eyes. Just so you know, the market broke out early November, the NASDAQ of 99, and just went insane to March 2000. And then good night, and then bounced up a little bit into Labor Day. That's when Intel in the year 2000, the day after Labor Day, warned, and then good night. I'm somewhat of a believer in looking backwards, you know that, but just based on pattern recognition, not necessarily, oh, crashes and smashes. We're just letting you know, if disaster lies ahead, listen carefully, we'll be on it. You got that? I can never guarantee, my business doesn't allow me to guarantee. But I can tell you, we'll be on it. And if moving averages get taken out, we'll be on it. If everything tops en masse, we'll be on it. Just like in the recent one was 21. All the growth stocks topping out and going night-night. We were on it. Interesting, I got about 9 emails from people recognizing what the market's doing right now, and it's not even close to 99. But the move since November is quite the stunning coast-to-coast, new yearly low to new yearly high on the small and mid-caps. Still below 2021 by a decent margin, but coming on. We'll just take it one day at a time. Very focused, hardworking, doing the job, closing our eyes, hold our nose, and pray. Now, as we tell you, we try, that doesn't work. But another good day with a little sell-off at the close. And to repeat, if the semis and financials are working, it is very tough to take the market down. The other question we're getting is, what happens to the market if we go into an economic dive? Well, again, we can't guarantee anything here. We got regulators. Good for them. We can tell you, though, history says profits recession equals market drop, especially with valuations up there. Simple as that. Right now, market ain't seeing it. We'll know it if it's coming. Rails, truckers, semiconductors, financials, economically sensitive, will top out, roll over, and go through a bearish phase, bearish process. We ain't there. In fact, you got some pretty strong patterns right now. Up next, this, that, and the other thing, and whatever else. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to...
What are we waiting for?
Well, what are you waiting for?
One, two, ready, go.
Action! Investor's Edge. With Gary Kaltbaum.
Full disclosure. There are certain things we do with markets, and there are certain things we avoid. We hate the tout artists, the scammers, the BS artists. We've seen people go on TV and tout dollar stocks that trade 20,000 shares a day, and then they go up 30% in a day in order to make them flush. We see newsletters that are just so full of crap. If you had stuck the newsletter in a cow field, you couldn't even find it because it would just mix in with all the cow dung. One of our big mantras, full disclosure, good and bad side, is we will not buy companies that have no sales. We rarely buy companies that lose money, though, when we recognize we're in a market that's paying up for big sales growth, even though companies have losses, every now and then. And the reason being is, first and foremost, in bear markets, the curtains come down and they all get crushed, destroyed, blasted. You just saw it in 21, 22. And part of that is the biotechs. I don't know how it came about, but in the last 15, 20 years, a slew of biotech companies with no sales, but in different stages of trying to come up with something, go public. And it pisses me off. And the reason it does is because I just don't think they should be public. But free markets, baby. And I can simply tell you, there are some biotech stocks that have been trading for 15 years in the public market. and have made 100% moves to the upside and 90% moves to the downside and back and forth and still haven't come up with anything. They're still in trials. And I've seen many that have gone from 100 down to a buck. And many have gone by the wayside. We avoid all of them. We don't have the stomach for it. Why? Because I'm going to guess since we really started talking about them here, Mm, 75 to 100 of them in the last 15, 20 years, maybe more. In trials, the placebo did better than the drug, and the stock overnight would drop 30, 50. I remember one dropped 90%. So we can't, we're never going to touch them. But we also miss out on the gainers. You pick your poison. We're just letting you know today. Symbol RYZB. RYZB. Was up 101% today to $61.40. Just came public at $18 in September. Treatment of cancer. Raise Bio, it's called. Amazingly, it's being acquired by Bristol Myers for $62.50. Looks like cash. They're paying $3.7 billion for a company with no sales. And they're just in clinical stages, which means that drug ain't coming out for a long while. We can safely tell you we own no shares. How about symbol GRCL? No sales. AstraZeneca is buying them out. Looks like about $1 billion. $19 IPO in the year 2000, went to 34, was as low as $1.40 in April of 23. Looks like they're being bought around 10 bucks after doing a $19 IPO. So for people that have the IPO, and by the way, this is a Chinese clinical stage, which means you got a long way to go, treatment of cancer. And I don't know the company. I don't know company. Yeah, they're being bought for 10 bucks. They do cell therapy across oncology and autoimmune diseases. I have no clue about these companies. I have not investigated them. I'm just letting you know two companies with no sales were bought out by two major pharmaceutical companies, Bristol Myers and AstraZeneca, paying a total of, what I say, $4.8 billion. I'll end the thought with this. Boy, I hope they come up with good stuff. I just had somebody that I knew since junior high pass away of multiple myeloma. Interesting that you used to die within a year getting it, lasted 6 years because of new. But the whole goal is to rid ourselves. I mean, cancer is just, I think every one of us knows somebody intimately or pretty close that has had it, gone through it, or worst case from it. So let's hope. Anyway, on the market front, we didn't own those two. Full disclosure. Never even heard of them before. Because we typically don't even pay much attention to them. For those that own the stock, good on you. Those who own the stock of Gracell Biotech at 19 IPO, well, not so good. And that's the story of the biotechs today. And I hope these companies did their due diligence well. And there's been much bigger buyouts than these two. Much bigger. Bristol Myers has a market cap of $104 billion. AstraZeneca has a market cap of $206 billion. Little did I know. So I guess they have the money in their Christmas club account to do this. All right. Tomorrow I'll be on with Charles Payne, Fox Business Network, 2 p.m. hour. Check it out. Other than that, I hope you had a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays so far as we head into the new year. You have a great evening. Drive carefully. And when you get home, do like we do. Quite simple. Make sure you hug the family. Make sure you hug your children. They will feel better. You will feel better. I promise. I appreciate all of you. Have a good night. Bye-bye.
This has been Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum on BizTalk. To listen to past episodes or to get in contact with Gary, go to GaryK.com. That's GaryK.com.